So if you see a child with vomiting and or diarrhea, what are key things you want to ask? First is obviously fever. Children with infectious diarrhea typically may have a fever. Ask about blood or mucus in the stool. This may tip you off that this is a bacterial as opposed to a viral pathogen. Most bacterial gastroenteritis requiring treatment is bloody. Ask about exposure to farm animals or reptiles. This is actually a really important question because a common cause of salmonella in children is reptile pets, and a common cause of E. coli, and especially the variety that causes hemolytic uremic syndrome, is from farm animal exposure. Petting zoos are a big problem in the United States if children don't wash their hands with alcohol after they pet the animals. Suspicious foods are always a potential cause, and we hear about outbreaks all the time, for example, E. coli and spinach. This happens periodically, and so when such a thing happened, you might ask about suspicious or also undercooked foods, things like uncooked eggs, which might show up in raw cookie dough. Ask about recent travel. Recent travel is important because there are some causes of diarrhea that are unusual in the United States that may be more prevalent in developing countries. And of course, ask about recent antibiotic use because C. diff is a possibility, as well as antibiotic-associated diarrhea. So on exam, critically important to look for signs of dehydration. Tenting is rare and is only at extreme ends of dehydration. Mostly, you're going to look at mucous membranes and see if they're moist. See if the child is making tears when they cry. Look for signs of systemic infection. Is there something else going on? The abdominal exam is critical, especially looking for rebound, guarding, things like that where the child doesn't want you pressing on their abdomen. In babies, this can be tricky. The baby, if you're careful, will seem to resist you if you squeeze on their belly. But in a crying baby who doesn't want to be examined in the first place, this can be a challenge. A perianal inspection is important on children, especially if you're concerned about inflammatory bowel disease. Sometimes a rectal tag or fissure is the best clue you have that the child has Crohn's disease.